Welcome to another State of the Game special. Alessandro Del Piero is one of the living icons of football on a global plane. He is among the most admired and gifted technicians to ever grace a football field and a winner of nearly every trophy available at world, continental and domestic levels. Remarkably, he has been among us in Australia for nearly two seasons now. His name and his affable presence and his football lifting the game's brand in the Australian consciousness. But in a matter of weeks, he will be at a crossroads as he agonises over some difficult choices, whether to play on after this season or not, whether to stay in Australia or not, and what to do in the event that he does retire from playing. Del Piero rarely gives one-on-one interviews, but he did grant SBS an extended chat for this program, where we spoke to him about his past, present and future, as well as his book, which interestingly is titled Playing On. Alessandro, thank you for giving us your time.
You're welcome. Thank you for
now, Alessandro, there's been a lot of public debate recently on your future in Australia. Once your contract expires at the end of this season, what is that future?
Honestly, I don't know at the moment, because it's for sure it's a particular moment for me. I understand how my body and my heart can move again for another year. And I think the next month, couple of months, I hope to understand exactly what.
Well, let me ask it again this way. Would you like to stay if that opportunity was there? Would you and your family like to continue living in Australia?
We spend a beautiful time, a wonderful time here in Sydney, in Australia. This is very important for us. What we are looking for, we are fine here. And it's the best for us spend these 2 years here. And if there's a good opportunity for stay, for sure. But I have to analyze what is also my job and what is my thought about the future. And but it's a great time here. Everything we loved, and now the kids start school again. And our life in Sydney is perfect at the moment.
Now, if you decide at the end of the end of all this to say arrivederci to playing football, would you like to coach? I don't mean any particular team.
Honestly, until 3 years ago, I said no, if you ask me the same question. Now, I understand, analyze, it's a very interesting job, be a coach. But it's another way. At the moment, I want to be focused about my present and for finish best I can this season, for think about the next one, if I can play or not, because the passion for me is play football, no, teach football.
Well, for all of us.
and this is the real question I have to answer about this question.
Okay. Can you confirm for me, Alessandro, that after Ian Crook resigned as Sydney FC coach last year, you offered your services to coach the team?
We was in a big trouble last year after that. And happened something good inside the team, and everyone looked at about me, about what we can do, and maybe I can help you. And I say, okay, if you think about that, if I'm really happy to give all my knowledge, but understand how is it was a problem because.
How would you have done it? What did you have in mind as the formula by which you would have been in charge?
I really don't know, because it's everything new for me. It was everything new, and still everything new for me. I have only my knowledge and nothing more, but I want to jump off of that moment and I say, okay, I'm here, use me, and say if you want some help, I'm here.
Yeah. But the club was not interested in that option?
No, the club, then in a couple of weeks, Frank arrived, and I think it's the best solution for everyone. probably no one in the world are perfect, but we can move better in our life if we have perfect thoughts.
We are assuming by your body language that you are enjoying living in Sydney, yeah. And you're enjoying the lifestyle. Are you enjoying your football?
I'm enjoying if I can win. And inside the pitch, everything can happen. There's a lot of moments inside the pitch. Sometimes I'm nervous, I'm angry, I'm happy. It's happened during the game, happened all of this. And especially if we are coming from not a very good moment and more problem, put more pressure inside of the team, inside of me. But it's just like I say all the time, every problem have to move us forward for resolve the problem. And this is what I want to do. This is what we want to do. And nothing else is. Last game was fantastic for everyone, and that's why if we are moving that way, in this way, we have more opportunity for play better and for winning also. Yeah.
You are very philosophical, which brings me to your book, which is entitled Playing On, and you focus much of the book on philosophies, with chapter titles like passion, friendship, resilience, honesty, beauty, sacrifice, style. You're a really deep thinking person, aren't you?
I try to. I don't think I'm perfect. I don't think probably no one in the world are perfect, but we can move better in our life if you have perfect thoughts. And that's why I try to analyze this book. That's why I try to write what I'm feeling during my career. And everything starts from the number 10, because there's 10 chapters. And I try for express what I feel in the past and now. Especially the title is everything for me,
yes.
Playing it on.
Now, you talk in much of your book about the challenge. There's a chapter dedicated to the challenge, and you're saying, the sense of challenge is the petrol that fueled my engine for 39 years.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you explain that to me?
When I do something, 99% of the time, it's a feeling involved inside like a challenge. Also, if I play with my children. Now is the moment I have to lead them and they have to win. But when they grow up, they will grow up. I wait the moment for challenge with them, because the challenge for me is everything inside the pitch And when I play with my teammates, when I played with my teammates in the past, when I was young, when we play in my garage, I want to challenge in everything. And after this, I can say, probably if I have a target, if I have a challenge in front of me, I can sprint, I can do better. I can sprint better of myself. And that's why I say challenge is the fourth.
You also talk a lot about choice and about having to make choices in life, which fascinates me because you have to make choices when you take penalties, and you take very good penalties. So what is going through you? How do you plan a penalty when you're just about to step up to kick that ball?
Mind? The penalty, you build the penalty before the kick for sure. And sometimes happen in training, sometimes happen start of the week, sometimes happen if you analyze the goalkeeper who is in front of you during the week, sometimes happen in the last few seconds before kick the penalty. It's, I try to do a lot of way, and the best for me is feeling prepare good all the week, all the options, and at the end leave my heart in a few seconds for understand what is the best way, mm-hmm. and follow my instinct is the best for me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you say in the book that Australia is not just a place, it's a state of mind.
Yes.
What do you mean by that?
Because for me, it's very far from Italy. It's a lot of things is different, and the football is different, the league is different, built with a different situation, and it's fantastic for me because it's a very great experience. Understand the football from a different point of view. In one moment, all your life, all my life in football was complete. The circle is complete.
memories of the 1982 World Cup, Alessandro? You were a little boy, which Italy won, of course, the last time, second last time Italy won. Did that play a role in your desire to become a footballer?
Yes, I'm completely in. I'm 8 years old. I played with my home team, and I wear the games with my flag, homemade. With a piece of wood, and my mama, they say cucire, inside. So, yeah. And this is my flag, and I wear the game, and when every time the Italy won, I put in the, I go outside in the road. Yeah. And
who was your idol in the team? This was the Paolo Rossi team.
For sure, Paolo Rossi had a great role, but that team is, I'm Juventus fan, that team, there's a lot of players from Juventus: Tardelli, Scirea, Cabrini, Gentile, Zoff, many players. And but when you're looking for Italy squad, it's all the team. It's part of the heart, the national team. That's why I don't care if score Rossi or another one. I'm happy because...
Well, they were not expected to win that World Cup. No. Just like a lot of people are not expecting Italy to win this time. And in 2006...
The same.
In extra time of the semi-final against Germany, critical goal, and then in the winning penalty shootout in the final. Was that your most treasured moment?
Yeah, for sure.
In your whole career?
Yeah, because the World Cup, winning World Cup complete your career. Yeah. When I grew up in Italy, or probably everywhere, but in Italy, If you think about dream in your life is winning the World Cup with your national team, and in that moment happened, and it's impossible to describe everything. And we can stay a couple of hours, and I can tell you a lot of different things. Probably confusion, because it's exactly what happened. In one moment, all your life, of my life for in football, was complete. The circle is complete. And you are lost, but happy, and lost again, and really happy. And then you start to think, it's happened, it's true. Don't wake up me, please. Yeah. And everything in
dream
the same moment.
Exactly. Now, there is a stigma in Australia and other parts of the world too about Italian football, that the Italians are besotted with results. Results is everything for them, that they are pragmatic above everything else, that they are defensive and never adventurous. How do you, as an Italian, react to those opinions?
Yeah. I heard this one.
This is a popular opinion around the world. Yeah. How do you respond?
I think it's true.
Yeah?
Yeah. Mm. I think it's true. I don't think we have to hide our potential. Yeah. This is our potential. This is our key. It's part of our natural situation. It's not a bad thing have a good defense or all the team defend good result, it's a good thing. And now the mentality it changed a little bit, and we play more. And also in 2006, we finished with the best defense, but we score with many different player, and sometimes we play with the three forwards, and let's say it's not.
Yeah, this is the Catenaccio is not.
The Catenaccio, I think, is now is finished for sure.
Yeah.
But still, the mentality of defense in Italy, and this is good for me.
Mm. Yeah. Now, just going back to your book finally, and that word, the challenge. Your adventure in Australia has also been a challenge.
Yeah.
Do you believe you've risen to that challenge?
It's a big challenge for me. It's a big jump for me. And everything can happen until now in the next period. It's everything is big. Because I'm come here after 19 years in the same place. And I changed everything in my life. I changed all the life of my family also. And we approach that with a lot of good thought, a lot of hope, a lot of everything. And for learn something different, for adapt, for take a different habit, for understand different people of us, for start to learn a little bit English.
You're doing just fine.
But it's a very great experience for us, for me.
Okay. Well, you are very kind. Lei è molto gentile. Mille grazie.
It's true. Thank you.